Though right now there are a lot of deals to be had if you are looking to rent, because landlords, they are slashing prices and offering deals in an effort to fill empty units vacated by people leaving the city as a result of the coronavirus pandemic. So joining me now is COO and co-founder of Urban Digs, John Walkup. I say it's a perfect name for someone in real estate to give us a sense of what this means and what impact it could have on the market down the line. Good morning, John.
Good morning, Betty. Thank you for having me.
Oh, it's great to have you. Okay, so typically during the summer months, we see a rise in rental rates, right? Because a lot of people wanting to move in and move out. But this year, it's a little bit different, obviously.
That's correct. You know, typically summer is by far the biggest, most busiest time for the rental market. And we've seen that the activity for new listings has continued at seasonal levels, but the number of units being rented is still at we're looking at much depressed levels. We're looking at about 50% of the ones coming on are being rented,
wow,
which is not good for landlords.
Yeah, so ideally, it for renters right now, it is a renter's market. So what kind of deals are you talking about?
Well, landlords have a few main channels they can use to entice renters back. Number one, of course, is cutting rent. The second is they offer concessions, such as a month free, 2 months free. And the third thing they can do is also offer credits for, say, closed amenities, such as gyms, things like that.
That equates to, what, thousands of dollars, right?
It can. In many cases, it depends on the rent, of course, but it can equate to thousands of dollars. So just be savvy and take a look at what's out there.
Especially if you can get 1, 2, or even 3 months rent knocked off. Hey, are there any particular neighborhoods that are experiencing more discounted rent prices than others?
You know, it really depends. You know, New York City is a city of neighborhoods, but in those neighborhoods, it's really all about the buildings and the landlords that own the buildings to make up the bulk of those rent and the great deals. So it really comes down to what the landlord's looking at in terms of their own personal vacancy rate. Some neighborhoods certainly are seeing ones. You're talking about the outlying areas of Brooklyn are seeing some. The Upper East Side, which typically has a number of rents happening during the summer, is also seeing some increased vacancy rates. So it really comes down to your personal neighborhood and the vacancy rate in that neighborhood and in the building.
Even with the incentives, is it a time to negotiate for renters? Can they cut themselves a better deal? And what are some of those negotiating tactics?
Certainly, you know, renters, the first thing they should do if they're looking to stay in their place is approach the landlord in sort of a transparent way and explain the situation. That's the number one thing they can do. The second thing they should be able to do is just constantly check the market, see what the comps are out there, see what similar units are renting for, what the asking rents are, see how they're different from yours. The third thing you can do is look at the timeline of your lease. If you're looking at a 1 to 2 year lease, that's the renewal. Try for a month to month if that's something that's a little more amenable to you.
Do you see this pattern continuing throughout the rest of the year and perhaps even into next year?
That's a great question. I don't think anybody knows what's going to happen with the rental market going into next year. Typically, as I said, the summer is the busiest period. We've really seen an increase in listings over the summer. We had a holiday weekend, and I think the next couple weeks as we get into July is really going to determine what's going to happen with the market.
All right. We appreciate your insights. Very valuable information. Could equate to, like we said, thousands of dollars. So good talking to you. And thank you for sharing some of that knowledge with us this morning. We appreciate it.
My pleasure. Thank you.